And joining us now from the State House is the state epidemiologist, Dr. Tina Tan. Dr. Tan, good to have you back on the program once again. Give me a sense of how you characterize the danger posed by contracting the West Nile virus.
Well, West Nile virus infection in general usually doesn't cause severe illness. Most people who are infected with West Nile virus don't have any symptoms at all, or otherwise might just have some mild illness. Typically speaking, if people do have symptoms, they tend to be mild, like fever or headache, body aches. But sometimes there may be some instances where people develop severe illnesses that could lead to confusion, paralysis, and possibly result in hospitalizations.
At this point, we have the one confirmed case thus far. Give me a sense of is this something that is very communicable? What's the danger posed by it and the fact that we have a case at this time of the year?
Right. West Nile virus is an infection that's transmitted by the bite of an infected mosquito. So anybody could be at risk of getting West Nile virus if they're potentially in contact with mosquito bites, particularly mosquitoes that are infected with West Nile virus. And, this is the time of the year that we start to see, or that we do see, mosquito activity right now. So this is the time of the year that people should take extra precautions to protect themselves against West Nile virus.
It was a few years ago when we first started hearing about this, and all sorts of conspiracy theories abounded and wonder about why this virus was showing up here. How long has it been around?
West Nile virus in North America has been around for a little over 10 years now, and we now see West Nile virus has established itself in North America, and we see it from coast to coast.
So it's something that we basically just have to learn to live with?
That's right.
Compared to some of the other mosquito-borne diseases and illnesses, how would you characterize it?
West Nile virus is an illness that, generally speaking, doesn't create huge complications, severe illness. There is a small proportion of people who might develop severe complications, and those people who are at higher risk for severe complications, such as encephalitis or meningitis, which is basically swelling and inflammation of the brain or the tissue surrounding the brain, as well as more severe neurological symptoms, these tend to be people who are over the age of 50, or people with weakened immune systems.
What about children?
Children are potentially at risk for complications related to West Nile virus illness, as with those other high-risk groups. So again, but on the other hand, anybody can become affected with West Nile virus in general, and it's hard to say sometimes whether or not there might be some other factors that could predict how severe an illness an individual could have.
Let's talk a little bit about geography involved here. Any part of the state, north versus south, central, east, west, that's more prone towards this?
Well, right now we have West Nile virus activity in mosquito pools throughout the state, with the exception of Cumberland and Salem County so far this year. So we do continue to monitor that type of West Nile virus activity among these mosquito pools throughout the mosquito season.
Do mosquitoes spread it amongst themselves? That's why it's becoming more prevalent?
Well, mosquitoes become infected by feeding on an infected bird after they take a blood meal from an infected bird. And that's typically how they become infected with the virus.
And as the birds, we've seen different kinds of birds suddenly showing up in our state as well. Does that change some of the dynamic here?
Actually, it does to a certain degree. We typically have seen West Nile virus emerge or be a problem among various crow populations, but we do follow it in conjunction with our various partners in environmental protection agencies to determine where the bird populations might be affected. We work closely with the local health departments to monitor that activity.
And New Jersey versus other states, how would you say we rank when it comes to the risk here?
Well, you know, the risk is everywhere in the United States where there are mosquito pools that are infected with West Nile virus. So in general, whenever you're in a area where there is a lot of active mosquito activity, whether it's in New Jersey during the summer months when mosquito activity is more pronounced versus other areas where mosquito activity might be more active throughout the year, it's important that people take precautions to prevent getting any sort of mosquito bite because of these issues of mosquito-borne illnesses such as West Nile virus.
Dr. Tan, we have to leave it there. We thank you once again.
Thank you.